backyard. Correct, but amen. The question is, what is your backyard like? And what is my backyard like? If we ask ourselves in the church, what is our backyard like? Jesus told a parable that's found in Luke chapter 13. I think maybe I should switch. All vote on that. All in favor say aye. Aye. Okay. Got the purple one now. Is that better? All say amen.
Amen. Amen.
And preach the same with the purple one. All right. So Jesus told a parable. It's down in Luke chapter 13. It's on your screen, verse 6 to 9. We just read it, but we're going to read it together. Let's all read it out loud. Okay? A man planted a fig tree. Are you with me? Okay? I didn't hear you. A man planted a fig tree in his garden and came again and again to see if there was any fruit on it. But he was always disappointed. Finally, he said to his gardener, I've waited 3 years and there hasn't been a single fig. Taking up space in the garden. The gardener answered, Sir, give it one more chance. Leave it another year. I'll give it special attention, fertilizer. If we get fixed next year, if not, then you can cut it down.
Backyard challenge. Can you all hear me ours now?
No.
It went off again.
Go to third time the trar, right? Let's go to mic number three.
I like gold. I like black mics. You know, black is my favorite color, as you can tell. Raider colors, right? All right, black white works. So God has called us to become disciples, the followers of Jesus. That's our theme for 2019, disciple-driven, to become more and more like Jesus. In our church, we have four covenants, or five covenants, actually. The first four we're generally comfortable with. Covenant number one, spend quality time every day with God. Bible study, prayer, listening to K-Love on the radio and gospel music, and just spending some time in the presence of Jesus, every single one of us. I think most of us are saying amen to that. That's good. Covenant number two, spending some good spiritual nurture with fellow believers in a small group setting or a Sabbath school class, because we can grow stronger as we fellowship and nurture each other in our Christian walk. I think we'd all say, okay, that's good, but I'm pretty good with that too. Worshiping together 75% of the time, coming together and singing praises to God and listening to children's stories and a sermon, that's a good thing to do, and not just bouncing around from church to church to church, watching on the internet and other things, and coming to church. I think all of us who are committed to Alhambra, we come most more often than not, and we're okay with that. And the fourth covenant, being financially supportive of the church budget, tithes and offerings. I think most of us, at least with lip service, are okay with that, and maybe practice it half the time, some of the time, most of the time. We're good with that. That's part of being a disciple. It's that fifth one, that fifth covenant that is like in our backyard, unattended, that just is there. Fifth one, be active with our spiritual gifts in ministry to grow and develop the church. Jesus used many different metaphors for the church. He called us to be fishers of men. Matthew chapter 4:19. Come, he told the disciples, come follow me and I will make you fishers of men. I will teach you how to catch men. Being a disciple is called to do that. He also used this garden metaphor like we've been talking about to make you a garden with a green thumb. I thought about going to Lowe's and I'm going to give you some green paint and I can paint my thumb. But I really don't have a born-in green thumb. But you know, just as a metaphor, but I forgot to do that and ran out of time. How to grow people